Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. Been trying to do a little bit of praying and stuff. The Lord had showed me some stuff, and he gave me a little word for you guys. I just want to tell you also, guys, that hopefully we're going to have the... we're about to go live with a new website, the Church Firstborn. The link is below here. So we got the chat room going already on the, you know, the original website, and we're getting it all ready to go live any day now, and getting everything going. If the Lord tarries, that's the question. I say it with meaning today. We say that flippantly, but the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to say it, just by the power of the Holy Spirit. If the Lord tarries. While I was praying, I saw several things from the Lord, brothers and sisters. But this is the thing that the Lord wanted me to share with you. I heard those wedding vows. And, you know, I've seen lots of videos, made lots of videos about different things from the Lord. But I don't gonna make a cute little video with the wedding vows and stuff. But the part I heard was like a voice was asking me, you know, do you take, you know, this, the Lord to be your husband and forsaking all others, forsaking all others. That's the part of the sentence that was emphasized to me. Forsaking all others. Are you ready and willing to forsake the things of this world for the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ in your life? You know, it's been said by famous people. I know there's people that don't know what they're talking about. But there was a woman of God who died in the 1970s or maybe 1970s. Her name was Catherine Kuhlman. And she said that if you want to have my anointing, like what I have, are you willing to pay the price? And that's the big question. Are you willing to pay the price to forsake all others that you might partake in the wedding supper of the Lamb? Listen to me, brothers and sisters, it's not by might nor by power, but by my Spirit, saith the Lord, God Most High, Creator of heaven and earth. Will you forsake all others and follow the Lord? Choose this day whom you will serve. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Multitudes and multitudes in the valley of decision, in the valley of Jehoshaphat. Goats to the left, sheep to the right of the Lord. Choose this day who you will serve. For the glory of the Lord and the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to tell you by His authority. Forsake all others now. Forsake all others now. Don't let those people pick and choose those Bible verses to deceive you with a false gospel. They always quote just one or two Bible verses. They don't quote the Bible verses where Jesus says, "He who does not pick up his cross daily and follow me is not worthy of me." Jesus said, "He who puts his hand to the plow and looks back is not worthy of me." Jesus said, "Come unto me, all ye who are burdened and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." The Lord has a yoke, even though it's light, even though it's easy, there is a yoke. We are His servants, His bondservants, bound to Him, not by might or by power, but by His Spirit. Don't let those people take those few Bible verses out of context and make you believe the lie that you can follow the devil and enter the kingdom of heaven. Because broad is the road that leads to destruction, but narrow is the way, and straight is the gate that leads to eternal life, and few are them that find it. And as the Word of God tells us, when the New Jerusalem comes down, as I've mentioned before, the Lord has just reminded me, as I was just looking at it yesterday, it says, those who are there are called, chosen, and faithful to be in the bride. When it talks about New Jerusalem coming down, lots of people say, oh, the city of Jerusalem is the bride. No, the bride, the church is in that city. when the New Jerusalem comes down. And to be part of the bride, the rapture, I'm talking about you want to go in the rapture, to put it in terms that people can get in their mind, not to mince words. If you want to be in the rapture, if you want to be part of the bride of Christ, you must be called, chosen, and faithful. Thank God Almighty that you have an opportunity to be called. As Paul tells us in Romans chapter 9, what if the Lord makes some vessels for destruction and some for honor? Who are you? What is the clay to say to the potter, why did you make me like this? Praise God. We've been called. We've been chosen. Now the question is, are you faithful? Have you forsaken all others for the Lord Jesus Christ? Have you forsaken all others? I'm sorry, I can't tickle your ears, for I have to answer to the Lord God Almighty. For the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to strengthen me to speak, not by might or by power, but by His Spirit. I'm not an ear tickler. You're on the wrong channel. But that you might be awakened, that the Lord might wake you and shake you up, that you might be found worthy in Christ today. May you be found worthy, called, chosen, and faithful today to be part of the bride of Christ. For the Lord gave me another word tonight. This night, the Lord spoke to me and He said, yet a little while and you shall see me again. Yet a little while and you'll see me again. For the Lord has been received up to the Father until the times of refreshing, until the times of refreshing, when the moon will turn to blood. And all of those things spoken of by the prophets of God, like the prophet Joel, shall come to pass in these last days. In these last days, they shall surely come to pass. Right now, I just want to pray. I ask you to pray with me right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Glory. Hallelujah. Yahweh. Robo siki daromo Yahweh. Hallelujah. Jesus, you are the Christ. You are the Christ, the Son of the living God, Lord. We welcome you, Lord. Lord, let your glory, hallelujah, touch those who watch this video, Lord. Let your peace, I release and speak the peace of the living God upon you right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's sing glory to the Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Lord, hallelujah. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord Jesus, hallelujah. To worship you, hallelujah, Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, Lord, hallelujah. Glory to your name, even so. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Lord, you are worthy. Yes, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. We praise you, Lord Jesus. Glory to your name, Lord God. Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah, O Lord, my God, hallelujah. Yes, Lord, hallelujah. Lord, you are, hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Lord, you are, yes, Lord Jesus, hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Lord, you are, thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord, we praise you, Lord. Lord, you are, praise you, Lord, the lover of my soul. Hallelujah, praise you, Lord. Brothers and sisters, I can only say and do what I see my Lord doing and what the Lord tells me to do. All other ground is sinking sand. As the song says, on Christ the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. For I wist not what man thinks of me, for I walk in the path that is set before me by my Most High God, my Lord and Savior, Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Christ, be exalted in this place. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Who ever heard of a king coming into a place and the trumpeters don't announce his arrival? Does not the servants go before the king and announce, behold, the king cometh to receive his kingdom. The kingdom of the Lord is at hand. The Most High, only begotten of the Father, cometh on the clouds with great power and glory to receive unto himself a bride without spot, without wrinkle, seated upon the throne with him in glory. Hallelujah. Blessed be the Most High God, creator of heaven and earth, who has lifted us by his love, lifted us from the miry clay, and set us upon a rock. And he has prepared a table for us in the presence of our enemies. Bless my soul, O Lord. Bless me, Lord, that I might be a blessing in this place, even as Abraham was blessed that he might be a blessing. Lord, bless your people, God Most High, that they might be a blessing and they might have the power of the Holy Spirit within them, that they might go before the throne of the Lord, declaring the arrival of the Most High God, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Blessed be his holy name, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Jesus is his name, Son of the living God. Bless his name, O Ancient of Days, and forget not all of your benefits, Lord, for you have given us a kingdom, and you've given us crowns, Lord, that you might rule and reign through your people, Lord God. Bless you, Father, creator of heaven and earth, Most High God, El Elyon, my Lord and my God. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord Jesus, for you are seated at the right hand of the Father, high above, far above all powers and principalities and fortresses of darkness and wickedness in high places. Bless your name, Lord God, creator of heaven and earth, for it is your good pleasure to give your kingdom to these little ones. Blessed be the Lord, God Most High, creator of heaven and earth, who has given good gifts to men that we might bring glory to his name in this place and in this earth. Blessed be the Lord, God Most High, creator of heaven and earth, who has anointed our heads with oil, that our cup might runneth over, that he has prepared a table for us in the presence of our enemies. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. For he is in us and with us and to us and through us, that the wisdom of God might be made manifest to this world through his bride. Glory be to God, creator of heaven and earth, who has saved us from the wrath to come. For behold, the wrath of God cometh upon this world. Even as we speak today, the wrath of God abides on this world and upon the children of the devil in this world. Come out from among them and be not filthy, and be not filthy minded, but be thou clean. Be thou made whole. Be thou holy and righteous and separated, even as the Lord God is holy and righteous, and above all, and in you all, and to you all, and through you all, children of the Most High God. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, for the Lord is with us and in us and among us. Blessed be his name, Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Christ. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, that you have redeemed us from among the weeds and the tares of this earth. Thank you, Lord, that you have called us by your name, that you have chosen us to manifest your glory, even as you did Abraham, even as you did Isaac, even as you did Jacob, even as you did Noah, even as you did Moses, even as you did Joshua, even as you did Paul, even as you did Peter and John. Lord, you've called us and chose us, O Lord, might we be found faithful this night. May we be found faithful in Christ, that when the bridegroom comes, that we be not caught in spiritual adultery. But we are looking and waiting and preparing and being dressed with our staff by the door and our food prepared to take with us on our journey as we go up and ascend to the heavenly Jerusalem, to Mount Zion, to the church of the firstborn, to the church of our Lord and our God. Lord, we praise your holy name tonight. We bless you, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord. And Father, we honor you, Lord. Let thy kingdom come, Lord. Let thy will be done, Lord. Let the fire of your spirit go forth, Lord God, through this video, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord, to set a spirit of holiness and repentance and urgency and fervency upon your people. I release, Lord, the anointing that you've put in me, Lord God, to proclaim this message. I release the fire of glory to go out upon your people, a fire of holiness, sanctification, separation, redemption, to go forward over this video right now in Jesus' name. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Blessed be the Lord God Most High. Hallelujah, Creator of heaven and earth. Bless you, Father, in Jesus' name. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord, O my soul and all that is within me. Bless you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Brothers and sisters, God bless you. The Lord just got me to make this video just to release a blessing and anointing upon you, to release the glory upon you that is of the Most High God, a river of living water be upon you right now in Jesus' name. Those who desire to be baptized in the Holy Spirit, those who desire to be healed, those who want to be repented and sanctified and be cleansed by the blood of Jesus, now is the time. Receive what God has for you. Receive the good gifts of God. Reach out and touch the hem of his garment. Hallelujah. For the Lord is passing by. He's still passing by. He's still passing by today. Reach out and touch the hem of the Lord Jesus Christ's garment. Be ye whole. Be ye cleansed. Be ye filled by the Spirit of the living God. May the Spirit of holiness overtake you. There is a baptism of fire. It's a fire of holiness, just like when the tongues of fire came down on the apostles, when it came down on the dedication of the temple of King Solomon, when it came down on the dedication of the tabernacle in the wilderness. It's a fire of holiness. We're not talking about the fire that's from the pit of hell, but the baptism of the fire of holiness and sanctification, dedicated to the Lord. As I began this video, by the Spirit of the living God, will you forsake all others? Forsake all others. Will you take the wedding vows to be part of the bride? Do you take the Lord to be your groom and forsaking all others? Will you give up the things of this world? Can you give up the things of this world? Do you really love me? Jesus is asking you. Do you really love me? Do you really love me? It's like he asked Peter, do you love me and feed my sheep? Will you forsake all others for the Lord? Can you forsake this world? Can you give up Sodom? Can you turn your back on Sodom today? Choose this day whom you will serve. By the grace of God and his mercy upon me and my house, we will serve the Lord. By his grace and with his help, except the Lord build the house, those that labor in vain. Psalm 127. It's not by might or by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. God bless you all. May the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be upon you. May the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be upon you. For the kingdom of heaven is at hand. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Can you understand that the kingdom of heaven is at hand? Understand that. Run to Jesus. Flee from the things of this world. Flee from obsessing about debating little doctrines and all this foolishness. And run to the groom. He is waiting for you. But the door is about to shut. In other words, be part of the wise virgins, not the foolish virgins. Don't let anyone deceive you. Whatever a man soweth, so shall he reap. Don't let any man deceive you with any false gospel. I don't care if 100 billion people believe that you can say a prayer when you're 8 years old and follow the devil and sleep and lie with the devil all your life in spiritual adultery. And then when the bridegroom comes and you say you're part of the bride and there you are in the bed with the devil talking about you've been faithful to Jesus, what groom is going to take you when you are playing a whore? Talk about spiritual adultery. Giving your heart to the things of this world, money, whatever it is. Literal idols like in the Philippines. People keep talking about idolatry in the Catholic Church. What about your idolatry? What about the things that you have not forsaken for the Lord? They say, as an example, only 2% of people tithe who are Christians. Obviously, lots of people want to serve mammon instead of the Lord. May the Lord God Almighty have grace and mercy on our souls every day and give us not what we deserve.